Hi there, Josh here with Evergreen Tutorials, and I'm going to show you how to use the DATEDIF function. First thing we're going to want to do is just go into a selected cell, type in equals DATEDIF, left parenthesis, quote, and now we're going to put in a start date. And we're going to have to format it with quotes. So we put 05, use a dash formatting, 1998, end quote, now comma, and now we're going to put in the end date. So start date, comma, end date. So I'm going to put in another date here, 05-12-2018. Now we need to put in a unit value. I'll explain that in a second, but for this case, I'm going to just use years. I want to know how many years have passed between that date and the next date. Put in quote y, right parenthesis, and we can see that 20 years have passed between those two dates. We have several different unit values. We have complete years, complete months, and complete days. Those are pretty self-explanatory. So for between one date and the next date, how many complete years have passed, so to figure out how old someone is perhaps. Or for the months, we have maybe how many payments are due on a loan. Or for days, for like, say you want to reward someone on their 1,000th day with the company, we can put in that argument there. We also have MD, YM, and YD. MD is difference in days, month and year ignored. So a certain date of the month, say 25, and then someone else is born on the 10th of the month, the difference would be 15 days, because we're ignoring the month, we're ignoring the year. We're only looking at 25 and 15. The next one is difference in months. So what's the difference between September and December? It would be 3. It'd be 3 months between that. And we have difference in days. The years are ignored. And I'm going to use YD in a second. We'll get to see how that works. So I have a class. They're graduating. And I'm going to use the date diff to figure out how old they were when they graduated. So I'm going to put in date diff, left parenthesis. Now here I'm going to reference the cell data. Hold down control, select the birth date. Now hold down control again, select the grad date, and I'm gonna put in the Y unit. So for years, figure out how many complete years have passed between their birth date and their grad date, and I will get their age. Press enter, and we can see that Kalos is 22 when he graduated. So instead of putting in this function, date diff, and typing this all out for the whole thing, we can go back up where we put in this function, go to the bottom right of the cell, hold the fill handle, and go down. So we go down to Gilo, and what happened here? There's a random number. Oh, wait a minute. They were born after they graduated. That doesn't make sense. We're going to just fix that. It's probably a typo that happened. 1999, and now it automatically fixes it for us. With this, we also have some more data issues. What we put into the date diff function is important. So you cannot be born on the 40th month. That doesn't make sense. We're going to make that 04. This says 1850. While that's not necessarily an error, Microsoft Excel has problems with any dates before 1900. Any dates before 1900 are not recognized as a year, and it will throw an error. So with this, I want to change this to, I can change it to 1950, and it fixes it. They were 67 when they were graduated. Great. And again, we cannot have the 60th day of the month. No months have 60 days. I'm going to change that to 26. And there we go. We have a list of how old people were when they graduated using the date diff function in all of these. Now we want to figure out how many days till their birthday, because my school likes to send out a birthday card, you know, after people graduate, saying congratulations for graduating, please come back, please visit us, or whatever. So I'm going to put in the date diff function again, left parenthesis, and I'm going to select the birth date, I'm going to select the grad date, and I'm going to put in the unit value of YD, end quote, right parenthesis, and we can see that they will have 334 days before their graduation. Again, use the fill handle for this, and we can see how many days we have until we need to send them a birthday card. I'm Josh here, and now you know how to use the date diff function in Excel. If you have any questions, please comment below and I'll be sure to get back to you. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.